Welcome to the greater Fort Lauderdale area. Tonight, Miss Florida USA 1984 will be selected live from the Parker Playhouse in Fort Lauderdale. 112 of Florida's most beautiful young women from throughout our Sunshine State are here in beautiful Broward County to compete in the title and crown of Miss Florida USA 1984. In just a few seconds, you'll meet all 112 candidates, but first, meet the reigning Miss Florida USA, Janet Chesser, and special guest performer, Jim Gibson.
Once in my life I have someone who needs me, someone I've needed so long. For once unafraid I can go where life leads me, somehow I know I'll be strong. For once I can touch what my heart used to dream of, long before I knew. Someone warm like you could make my dreams come true. Where you going, Janet? For once in my life, I won't let sorrow hurt me. No, not like it's hurt me before. For once I have someone I know won't desert me. I'm not alone anymore. For once I can touch, this is mine, you can't take it. Long as I have love, now I know I'm gonna make it. For once in my life, I have someone who needs me. Isn't she lovely? Where's everybody going? Isn't she wonderful? Isn't she precious? Pretty enough to hold. I never thought through love we'd see one as lovely as she. But isn't she lovely, made from love? Yeah, no. Isn't she precious? The best. Boy, I'm so happy. No, I have been heaven blessed. I can't believe what God has done, given us such a pretty precious one. But isn't she lovely? She's lovely. She's lovely. I can't believe this is for real. Live television. You are the sunshine of my life. No, that's why I'll always be around. You are the apple of my eye. Forever you'll stay in my heart. I feel like this is the beginning. No, though I've known you for a million years. And if I thought our love was ending, I'd find myself drowning in my own tears. Not going anywhere. You are the sunshine of my life. That's why I'll always be around. You are the apple of my eye. Forever you'll stay in my heart.
The 1984 Miss Florida USA pageant is brought to you by Maybelline, the complete line of fabulous cosmetics for eyes, lips, and face, and the latest easy-to-wear fashion shades. Everything you need for a more beautiful you comes from Maybelline. And by the Broward County Tourist Development Council, Greater Fort Lauderdale, Hollywood, Pompano Beach, Lauderdale by the Sea, and Deerfield Beach. There's no greater fun under the sun. Stay tuned to meet our 112 candidates for the title of Miss Florida USA 1984 after this.
Maybelline thinks you should be pampered all the way to your lashes. That's why they invented a mascara so rich, so gentle, it's named Rich and Gentle. Rich thickness plus gentle care. How thick? You choose with the exclusive Maybelline Dial Control.
Feel free to use all you want. It washes off without irritating rubbing. The gentle formula pampers your lashes. Rich thickness plus gentle care.
Rich and Gentle Dial Control Mascara. Only from Maybelline.
Greater beaches, greater courts, greater racing, greater sports. Hollywood, Pompano Beach, Lauderdale by the sea. If it's in greater Fort Lauderdale,
it's the greater place to be.
Greater dining, greater sights, greater days and greater nights.
Meet our master of ceremonies, Dick Lamb, and TV hostess Miss USA 1982, Terry Utley.
Thank you, and good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Buenas noches, traigo saludos y cariños a todos mis amigos latinos.
Now that greeting, outstanding, done very well, is not only for our viewers all over the state of Florida, but into the seven Latin American countries that we'll be reaching with this telecast this evening. Right. We would like to say welcome to you to our 1984 Miss Florida USA pageant. We're glad to be here in Fort Lauderdale in the heart of beautiful Broward County. And of course in the Parker Playhouse. 112 beautiful young ladies from all over the states just descended upon this place this week, and it's a great place to present them as they compete for the title of Miss Florida USA. Now this lady has had one heck of a year. Tell me about it. It's been something else.
It's been very exciting, very fast, a lot of growing, a lot of new experiences. I can say that I won Miss Arkansas in April of 82, won Miss USA in May of 82, and then I just relinquished my crown this last May.
And you sandwiched a trip to Lima, Peru in there somewhere.
Oh yes, to Miss Universe, right.
And you've done a great job in representing us everywhere you have been, and we look forward to working with you tonight.
Thank you very much.
Terry Utley, Miss USA of 1982. We're all ready to begin. Our contestants are going to take the very first step now toward that title, and here they are, our Miss Florida USA Parade of Contestants.
Good evening, I'm Patricia Miller, I'm from St. Petersburg, and I'm 19 years old.
Hi, I'm Kimberly Polson, I'm 23 years old, and from Delray Beach.
Hello, my name is Maggie Ramirez, I'm 20 years old, I'm from Miami.
Good evening, I'm a 20-year-old from Tallahassee, Florida. Ladies and gentlemen, I am Kimberly Scarborough.
Hi, my name is Karen Menendez. I'm from Tampa, and I'm 20 years old.
Hello, everyone. My name is Dana Stinson. I'm 18 years old, and I'm from Deerfield Beach.
Hi, my name is Eileen Ravello. I'm 19 years old, from Miami Lakes.
Hi, I'm Tisha Anglin from Valrico, and I'm 18 years old.
Hello, my name is Christine Kelly. I'm 20 years old, and I'm right here from Fort Lauderdale.
Good evening. I'm Susie Dorman from Windermere, and I'm 20 years old.
Good evening, I'm Erin Perry. I'm 21 years old from Deerfield Beach.
Hello, I'm Sandra Walters. I live in Fort Lauderdale and I'm 23 years old.
Hello, my name is Meg. I'm 20 years old and I'm from St. Petersburg.
Good evening, I'm Belinda McDuffie. I'm 21, I'm from St. Cloud.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name's Audrey Ann Monroe. I'm 18 and I live in Fort Lauderdale.
Good evening, my name is Diane Scholler, I'm 19 years old, and I'm from Hollywood.
Good evening, my name is Betsy Camadeca, I'm 20 years old, and I'm from Tierra Verde.
Good evening, my name is Pamela Vipperman, I'm 20 years old, and I'm from Fort Lauderdale.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Elizabeth Marshall, I'm 20 years old, and I'm from Tallahassee, Florida.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Sandy Cummings, I'm 18 years old.
And I'm from Gainesville.
Good evening, my name is Lori Urbanek. I'm age 17 and I'm from Fort Lauderdale. Thank you.
Good evening, my name is Leslie Bell. I'm 18 years old and I'm from Hollywood.
Good evening, my name is Rowena Anderson. I'm from sunny Fort Lauderdale and I'm 22. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Jamie Nichols. I'm 18 years old, and I'm from Fort Lauderdale.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Yvette Perez. I'm from Miami, and I'm 20 years old.
Good evening. My name is Julie Chiburka. I'm 23, and I'm from Pompano Beach.
Good evening. I'm Leanne Jacobowski. I'm 20 years old, and I'm from Winter Park.
Good evening. My name is Becky Rodriguez. I'm 22 years old, and I'm from Miami.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Jennifer Steele. I'm 20 years old, and I'm from Odessa.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Anissa Mathis. I'm 17, and I'm from Jennings.
Good evening. My name is Robin Gallus. I'm 23, and I'm from Miramar.
Hello, everyone. My name is Elizabeth Cook. I'm 21 years old, and I'm from North Fort Myers.
Good evening, Florida. My name is Colette Glencross. I'm 19 years old, and I'm from Valrico.
Good evening, everybody. I'm Renee Pfeiffer. I'm 18 years old, and I'm from Miami.
Good evening. I'm Renee Baden. I'm 20 years old, and I'm from Jacksonville.
Hi, I'm Suzanne Stokel. I'm 22 years old, and I'm from Lutz, Florida.
Good evening, and welcome. I'm Lynn Haynes. I'm from Tallahassee, Florida, and I'm 20 years old.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Christine Phan. I'm 20 years old, and I live right here in Lauderhill.
Hi, my name is Allison Taylor. I'm 22 years old, and I'm from Fort Lauderdale.
Good evening. I'm Kellyanne Murphy. I'm 23 years old, and I'm from Gainesville, Florida. Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Bambi Blues. I'm 21 years old, and I'm from Gulf Breeze, Florida.
Hello, I'm Penny Staffa. I'm 19 years old from Deerfield Beach.
Hi, I'm Kimberly Clark from Spring Hill, and I'm 17 years old.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Lori Martinez. I'm 20 years old, and I'm from Miami.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Teresa Burke. I'm 22 years old, and I'm from Miami.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Angel Sangi from Orlando, and I'm 19 years old.
Hello, everyone. I'm Monica Jeffcoat. I'm from Key West, the southernmost city. I'm 18 years old.
Good evening. My name is LaWanda Wilson. I'm 19 years old, and I'm from the friendly city of Zephyr Hills.
Good evening. I'm 19-year-old Brenda Yellow from Miami.
Good evening. My name is Eileen Case. I'm 18 years old, and I'm from Miramar.
Good evening. I'm San Juan Griffin. I'm 23 years old, and I'm from Clearwater.
Hello, my name is Patricia Curry. I'm 22, and I'm from Miami.
Hello, I'm Jamie Heckman. I'm 22, and I'm from beautiful Clearwater.
Hello, my name is Michelle Weldon. I'm 20 years old, and I'm from Jacksonville.
Hello, my name's Susan Gentile. I'm 22 years old, and I'm from St. Petersburg.
Hello, my name is Lisa Johnson. I'm 21 years old, from White House Point.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Linda Ludwig. I'm 20 years old, and I'm from beautiful Miramar.
Good evening. My name is Ann Leisha. I'm 20 years old, and I'm from the city of Plantation. Thank you.
A warm round of applause for the first half of our contestants. That's right. We've only just begun. You've only met half of them. And in just a moment, we'll introduce the other half. But right now, Terry Utley has a very interesting guest. Margaret Gardner, the Miss Universe of 1978, who is now a model, a successful author, and also one of the distinguished members of our panel of judges for tonight's pageant. Terry?
Margaret, what I would like to know is, just how did Miss Universe, or being Miss Universe, change your life?
Well, I was a totally different girl who gave up the title from the one that won the contest. I traveled throughout the world. I got to meet very many interesting people, diplomats, people I would never have encountered in my everyday life.
Yes, I know what you mean, being Miss USA, it was the same way for me. Well, what I want to know, after you gave the title up, how did your life change? What kind of doors were open for you?
There were very many. Eileen Ford saw me in the Miss Universe contest, and she invited me to participate in her modeling school in New York. And I lived there with my runner-up, Judy Anderson, for 5 years. I had a wonderful time.
That sounds like a lot of fun. I had a great time living with Miss Universe this year. What I want to know is for you to tell us a little bit about your beauty book. You didn't say anything about that.
Well, it deals with clothing, hair, makeup, exercise routine. There are a couple of diets in as well, so anybody who's out there who needs some help, you should get hold of my book. And It just tries to promote the idea that you don't have to only be beautiful, you must also be nice inside to be liked.
I think that's so right. Thank you, Margaret. It's certainly a pleasure having you here tonight, and quite an honor. We've just met our first one half of our parade of contestants, and we have 53 more to go. We'll be seeing those contestants in just a few moments, but first, this station break.
Your makeup may help hide a wrinkle, but mine can actually help prevent wrinkles from coming along too soon. My makeup is Moisture Whip by Maybelline. Moisture Whip is formulated with moisturizers and Patamate O, so it protects you from dryness and too much sun to actually help prevent wrinkles from coming along too soon. Moisture Whip, beautiful makeup by Maybelline. It's good for you to look beautiful.
Greater beaches, greater courts, greater racing, greater sports. Hollywood, Pompano Beach, Lauderdale by the sea. If it's in greater Fort Lauderdale,
it's the greater place to be.
Greater dining, greater sights, greater days and greater nights. Greater ports and greater sales.
Greater what?
Fort Lauderdale.
Welcome back to the Miss Florida USA pageant from Fort Lauderdale, and let's continue now with our parade of contestants.
Hello, my name is Dion Nazaro. I'm 22 from Pompano Beach.
Good evening, I'm Renee Wade. I'm 23 years old and from Homestead.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Robin Green. I'm 19 years old and I'm from St. Petersburg.
Good evening, I'm Kathy Morton. I'm 21 years old and I'm from Hialeah.
Good evening, my name's Lillian Perez. I'm 18 years old and I live in Fort Lauderdale.
Good evening, my name is Alicia Wilson. I'm 18 years old and I live in Fort Lauderdale.
Good evening, my name is Frances Murphy. I'm 21 years old and I'm from Miami.
Hello, I'm Lonnie Fernandez, a 20-year-old from Clearwater.
My name is Sandy Piero. I'm 20 years old and I'm from Crystal River, Florida.
Hello, my name is Penny Perkins and I'm from Miami.
Hi, my name is Jody Gruber. I'm 21 years old from St. Petersburg.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Kimberly Roberts. I'm 22 years old from Hillsborough Beach.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Felipa Tucker. I'm 22 years old from Tampa, Florida.
Good evening. My name is Alicia Mulliken. I'm 20 years old from St. Petersburg Beach.
Hello, everyone. I'm Pamela Stein from the sparkling town of Clearwater, and I'm 20 years old today.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Lourdes Perea. I'm 19 years old, and I'm from Miami.
Hi, I'm Karen Chapman. I'm from right here in sunny Fort Lauderdale, and I'm 22.
Hi there, I'm Donna Brooks. I'm 23 years old and I'm from Winter Garden.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Rebecca Marshall. I'm 18 years old and I'm from Tallahassee.
Good evening. My name is Cindy Tullis. I'm 19 years old and I'm from Mulberry.
Good evening, everybody. I'm Linda Haber. I'm 20 years old and I'm from Fort Lauderdale.
Welcome. My name is Marilyn Valentine. I'm 19 years old and I'm proud to be from Okeechobee, Florida.
Hi, my name is Denise Duffy. I'm 20 years old and from North Miami Beach, Florida.
Good evening, I'm Peggy Nossen, 22 years old from Lakeland, Florida.
Good evening. Good evening, I'm Michelle Sharp. I'm 20 years old and I'm from Hollywood.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Gusty Nessel. I'm 20 years old and I'm from Hollywood.
Greetings, I'm Adrian McCray. I'm 21 years old and I'm from Delray Beach.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Catherine Armaday. I'm 22 years old from Fort Lauderdale.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Robin Stamm. I'm 20 years old and I'm from West Palm Beach.
Good evening, my name is Tracy Mavis. I'm 22 years old from Lake Worth, Florida.
Good evening, my name is Susan Fraser. I'm 19 years old and I'm from Port Charlotte.
Good evening, my name is Dana Hilliard. I'm 19 years old and I'm from St. Petersburg.
Hello everyone, I'm Julie Sims. I'm 22 years old and I'm a native of West Palm Beach.
Good evening, my name is Don Icampo. I'm 22 years old from Tallahassee.
Good evening, my name is Rosa Vasquez. I'm 18 and I'm from Hialeah.
Good evening, I'm Margie Coppinger from Miami and I'm 22 years old.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Darlene O'Brien. I'm 20 years old and I'm from Palm Beach Gardens.
Good evening, I'm Mary Boney. I'm 19 years old and from Miami, Florida.
Good evening, I'm Vivian Montez and I'm 22 years old and I'm from Fort Lauderdale, Florida.
Good evening, I'm Joni Boyles. I'm 17 years old and I'm from Coral Springs, Florida.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Marty Reisinger. I'm 21 years old and I'm from Fort Lauderdale.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Evelyn Norris. I'm 23 years old and I'm from Jacksonville, Florida.
Hello, my name is Cynthia Buchanan. I'm 19 years old and I'm from Key West, Florida.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Shirley Cross and I'm from Live Oak, Florida and I'm 21 years old.
Good evening, my name is Roxanne Reiner. I'm 21 years old and I'm from North Bay Village.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Sherry Hickok. I'm 19 years old and I live in Fort Walton Beach.
Good evening, I'm Rhonda Gerke. I'm 20 years old and I'm from Coral Springs.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Deborah Lupo. I'm 19 years old and I'm from the city of Sunrise.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Lisa Campbell. I'm 21 years old and I'm from Fort Lauderdale.
Hello, I'm Diane Hines. I'm 21 years old from Pompano Beach.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Patty Iglesias. I'm 19 years old and I'm from Miami.
Hello, my name is Krista Hendricks. I'm 19 years old from Miami.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Kelly Jordan. I'm 21 years of age and I'm from Apopka, the indoor foliage capital of the world.
Hello, my name is Stacy Hofsperter. I'm 19 years old from Tallahassee.
Now, there you have it. You have now met every one of our contestants for the title of Miss Florida USA. Indeed so. Last night, we completed our preliminary competition, and in just a very few minutes now, we will have from our judges the results of that competition when we narrow that number of great-looking young ladies behind us on this stage down to just 15. 15 semifinalists. That's all we'll have as they continue to compete for this title this evening. Now, there are two other special awards. One is Miss Amity, and the other is Miss Photogenic. And to help us with those awards this evening, once again, the reigning Miss Florida USA, Janet Chesser. Janet, 21 years old from Ormond Beach, and it was right here at Parker Playhouse 1 year ago where she captured the hearts of the judges and our viewers and started her reign as Miss Florida USA, a reign, by the way, that has really taken her some places in travel. For instance, you visited London, I know.
Yes, I did. This November, I had the chance to go to London, England, and represent the state of Florida for the Tourist Development Department of Broward. It was for the World Travel Trade Show, and it was quite an experience.
I know you've met lots of interesting personalities all across the country. I know you got together with Bob Graham, the governor of Florida.
Yes, I did. I had the chance to meet the governor, and it was very nice. I went up to Tallahassee, and he wished me good luck right before the Miss USA pageant.
You've done a good job as Miss Florida USA, Janet. I'm going to ask you to do one job right now. Did you bring us a message?
Yes,
indeed you did. We have first, let me see if I can get this turned around. First, we have Miss Amity. Now, this is voted on by all of the young ladies in the pageant. They choose from among them the friendliest, the most congenial, most helpful of their number as they've come together these 3 or 4 days to compete in the pageant. And let's see about their decision. For Miss Amity, this year is Lori Martinez. Our congratulations to Lori. The next award is that of Miss Photogenic. Now, Miss Photogenic, chosen by the photographers, the cameramen from the television crews that work this particular pageant, and their choice, well, look what they've done to us now, Mom. We've got a tie. Not one, but two came out in the voting for Miss Photogenic. The first is Robin Green.
Hello,
tonight for Miss Photogenic, Diane Scholler. Now, Diane picked up that cue rather nicely, I'll tell you that, because you're right. We only have one trophy for tonight, but we'll take care of that very short order. Thank you and congratulations, Miss Amity, and both of you who share the title of Miss Photogenic.
Congratulations, Miss Amity and Miss Photogenic. Who will be Miss Florida USA 1984? Well, in just a few moments, we'll have a better idea when the top 15 are announced. In selecting the top 15, the judges got to see the girls last night in preliminary competition when they performed in their swimsuits and their evening gowns, and previously they had personality competition with the judges. Each category is worth the same. In a few moments, we'll be hearing that announcement, but first, this message.
You are our inspiration. Maybelline knows how you use eyeshadow, so we created new Expert Eyes, the first shadow kit matched to the way you use it. You get lots more lip color.
Because you use more. Experts matched the contour and highlighter and added makeup tips right in the package.
That's why it's guaranteed to make you an expert. Expert Eyes, with lots more lid color. It's matched to the way you use it.
For you, from Maybelline.
Now there's a place where make-believe really does come true. Roger Brown's World of Miniature Horses. Fall in love with tiny horses that perform for you and swim in their very own pool. They'll even pose for pictures. See them run and play on 15 acres of fun. There's nothing like it in Florida. The World of Miniature Horses, West Atlantic Boulevard, Pompano Beach, opens Saturday, July 16th.
We wish to pay a special moment of thanks to those who have contributed to the success of this year's pageant. Housing for the pageant staff and all contestants has been provided by Howard Johnson's Lauderdale by the Sea, the official host for this year's Miss Florida USA pageant. Howard Johnson's offers you all the vacation comfort you look forward to, right where you want to be. Thanks to Carry Systems Regal Limousines of Fort Lauderdale, the new Miss Florida USA 1984 winner will be whisked away from Parker Playhouse in a luxurious chauffeur-driven limousine to begin an enchanting and exciting year of reign as Miss Florida USA 1984. Gary Fronrath Chevrolet for the official automobile for 1984 Miss Florida USA.
Well, here it comes, the tough part. We're going to look, as our judges did, at all of these beautiful contestants, and they have named just 15 semifinalists. Now, after we name those 15, they will compete, they alone will compete, in personality, swimsuit, and evening gown competition as semifinalists. May I have that envelope, please? Thank you, sir. Ah, that familiar buzz that goes through the audience and through the contestants behind me. I will read these at random, ladies. No particular order. Best of luck to each one of you. Our first semifinalist is Lori Martinez. Semi-finalist, Kimberly Scarborough. The next semi-finalist, Kimberly Roberts. The next name on our list, Michelle Weldon. And now we name Kathy Morton. Next semi-finalist is Diane Scholler. The next semi-finalist, Lisa Campbell. Lisa making her way out from the group to take her position as a semi-finalist. And next, Krista Henricks. Semi-finalist, Stacy Hosferter. The next semi-finalist is Robin Gallus. Five more names to read, and the next, Lonnie Fernandez. Next, Julie Ann Choberka. Down to just three names, and the next semi-finalist is Lynn Haynes. That leaves us with two. The next semi-finalist, Susan Gentile. One more name. Our next semi-finalist is Leanne Jacobowski. There you have our 15 semi-finalists for the title Miss Florida USA. Now, in just a moment, we'll be all set to talk to each one of these semifinalists. But first, Terry Utley has a fun segment that was videotaped earlier this week. Terry?
That's right, Dick. Some of our contestants were very busy before the pageant, taping for tonight's telecast. These fortunate contestants did what Fort Lauderdale is most famous for. They took a little vacation. Here's Leslie Bell, Mary Boyney, Roxanne Reiner, and Penny Staffa on their trip aboard the beautiful 46-foot yacht, The Escapade, to have some fun with the song Vacation by the Go-Go's.
We'll be right back.
That sure looked like fun. I'm glad they all made it back in time for the pageant. Now, Dick Lamb is going to give us and the judges a chance to get to know our 15 semifinalists. This is the first of three categories. It's called the personality competition. After this, we'll be seeing each of the contestants in swimsuit and evening gown. Let's begin the competition.
We use material that's supplied to us by the young ladies when they join the pageant. We just take a look at some of the information that they have provided and chat with them. It gives our judges a chance to see how they react in this circumstance. Let's start with Lori. Lori Martinez, Warner Southern College.
Yes, that's right.
What are you studying there, Lori?
Communications broadcasting.
Now, what are you going to do with that kind of background when you get out of school?
I'd like to work in TV, and I'd really like to be a TV host and be on stage.
You know, you also mentioned something else that sounds like you'd like to be on stage. When it says you sing, play guitar?
Yes, I do.
What kind of music do you do?
I do gospel, pop, and contemporary.
And now Lori would like to do a medley of four of her favorite songs right here.
Right.
Maybe some other time, right?
Okay.
Lori, thank you and good luck.
Thank you very much.
Lori Martinez. Kimberly Scarborough is next, and Kimberly is from Tallahassee, Florida State University, 20 years old. Let's see if we can find out about you. Interior decorating, are you really into that? You like to do that?
Yes, sir, I love to do that.
You think perhaps you could follow that professionally in later years?
I certainly hope so.
Do you have a very neat room at home?
Yes, both rooms. I have a beach house, and it's really pretty. We like to build a lot, my parents do, and I try to help them out as much as I can. I do some work for jewelry stores and department stores in Tallahassee. I decorate their stores for them.
Kimberly, you're also a well-spoken young lady. Good luck to you.
Thank you, Dick. I appreciate
Thank
it.
You. Kimberly Scarborough. Join me here, Kimberly Roberts, the second Kimberly that we have from Hillsborough Beach, 22 years old. Into running, at least it seems as such here. You mentioned running. You also mentioned... that was in another area, but do you do some running?
I sure do. I just finished my first marathon in January, and it was real successful. My goals, I had two. One was to run it under 4 hours, and the other was to run it comfortably, and I accomplished both. So it was a great experience.
How'd you get excited about running?
I started about 5 years ago in high school running cross country, and because I didn't have a car, it was the fastest way to get someplace, so that's really how I started.
You're moving pretty fast this evening, too, Kimberly. Good luck to you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Kimberly Roberts. This is Michelle Weldon, Florida State, 20 years old, and you do some modeling. Is that true?
Yes, I do. I'm currently modeling in New York right now, and I'm very excited about it.
How do you see yourself 4 or 5 years in the future?
Oh, hopefully with a larger agency in New York, maybe on Broadway. I'd love to be an actress.
Now, how much time do you have to spend at Florida State if you're doing all this modeling?
Well, I've completed 2 years at Florida State, and I have decided I'm going to take a year and work up in New York and to see if I can get my career started. If it does go as planned, I will continue my education up there.
You sure sound like you've got those plans down firm. Good luck.
Thank you very much.
That is Michelle Weldon. And Kathy Morton from Hialeah, 21. Oh, Kathy is one of... 8 kids in the family.
Yes.
Tell me what kind of advantages or disadvantages that provides one.
Well, it has both a lot of advantages and disadvantages. A lot of the disadvantages are you have to call when you want to take a shower. You have to say, I get the shower first, and whoever calls in order, that's the order you get it. And a lot of advantages are, you know, you always have someone that loves you very close, and there's always someone you can count on.
You in the middle, oldest, youngest?
I'm the baby.
Well, baby, you've come a long way, and you're doing nicely here tonight.
Thank you.
Kathy Morton. Now, Diane Scholler from Hollywood, 19 years old, and says, prized possession is a 4-foot Smurf. Well, for Smurf's sakes, Diane, where did you get that?
Well, I was in New York, and I was in a beauty pageant, and this stranger just came up to me, gave me this big 4-foot Smurf and said, here, this is for good luck. And I won, so it means a lot to me.
You see what happens when you talk to strangers?
I try not to, but I end up talking to them anyway.
Diane, you're doing well also here this evening, and best wishes the rest of the way.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Diane Scholler. Next, it is Lisa Campbell, 21 years old, Fort Lauderdale, Florida State University, into dancing and gymnastics, and would like to operate her own aerobic dance studio. Now, you really sound like you're interested in that. What's your background in dancing?
Well, right now I'm a Golden Girl at Florida State, and that's a dance team. We dance at halftime at the basketball games, and I've never had any professional training, but I pick it up fast.
Where did you get your interest, do you suppose?
Ever since I was a little girl, I've been interested in staying fit and always doing something, and I've just always been active.
All right, and active you are. Good luck to you, Lisa.
Thank you so much.
Lisa Campbell. So we've met just seven of our semifinalists, and we will meet the rest in just a moment after we take time out for you to see these messages.
Lips are gonna drive people wild.
With a sleek design in lipstick, Ultra Slim by Maybelline. Ultra Slim lipstick is long and slim with a slant tip for easy control. To go easy around the curves, easy around the corners, to shape beautiful lips in racy, creamy colors.
Your lips are gonna drive people wild. Ultra Slim lipstick by Maybelline.
This vacation, do something sensational in Greater Fort Lauderdale. Stay 3 days, 2 nights from just $29 each, including a lot of bonuses, like discount coupons good for big savings at award-winning restaurants and loads of Greater Fort Lauderdale attractions. Imagine 3 days, 2 nights starting at $29 each. Call toll-free 800-432-5545 for details. The Greater Fort Lauderdale vacation, it's sensational.
Beautiful flowers and plants for tonight's show and finalists' presentations has been provided courtesy of South Miami's Ernie's Wayside Gardens. To enhance and protect all those beautiful suntans, each one of tonight's lovely contestants will receive a gift package of suntanning products from Aloe Cream. While enjoying her prize vacation in New York, the new Miss Florida USA will be the guest of the Halloran House. The helicopter and pilot used in cooperation with the official pageant cinematographer was provided courtesy of Le Club International. And for pre-taped segments, special thanks to Sue Gordon's Bridal Salon for lending elegance and beauty with her lovely selection of bridal and ballroom gowns. And to Griff's Western of Davie for providing Western clothing for our contestants participating in the Boy from New York City production number of our show. Transportation for the contestants was provided courtesy of Gray Line Bus Company.
Back we are with the rest of our semifinalists and ready to chat with Krista Hendricks, student at UCLA and wants to attend law school and practice criminal law. Now tell me why.
Well, I've always liked a challenge, and I think criminal law would be the most challenging of all the fields of law, more so than tax law or something like that, and I'm looking forward to it.
Somebody in your family in the law business?
No, none of them are. Anyone would like a lawyer in the family.
Well, you just well may be it.
I hope so.
Krista, good luck to you.
Thank you very much.
And there is Krista Hendricks. Stacy Hosferter. Florida State, 19 years old. You want to work in the entertainment field?
Yes, I do.
How so? What do you want to do?
Well, I'd like to model, and I'd like to become an actress one day.
Are you doing anything toward that now, Stacy?
I'm modeling, and I'm taking theater at Florida State.
Now, in taking theater, have you done anything on stage yet?
No, I haven't. Just now.
Hey, you're doing all right. And I think that you're going to be seen on a lot of stages, believe me.
Thank you.
Thank you. Good luck. Robin Gallus, 23 years old, Pelican Aviation Flight School. I take it you're trying to get the flying license.
A pilot's license. I'm trying to get a single engine license. I'm just starting.
Tell me why. What are you going to do once you have it?
Well, I could always be an instructor, but I'd have to get that license too. But I just love to fly. I love being up in the airplane.
How about a profession? What kind of work do you like to do?
Well, right now, I've been doing some modeling work, so that's what I've been trying to do.
The flying model.
Yes.
Looks good in lights, don't you think?
Yeah, it looks great.
All right, Robin, good luck to you.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Robin Gallus. Lonnie Fernandez is next, Troy State University, 20 years old, from Clearwater. Oh, here's another lady who'd like to be a television broadcaster. Now, what do you mean, news or a talk show?
Well, just about anything. Right now, I work at the television station at the university, and I do anything from audio to graphics to doing the weather.
Who's your favorite lady on television?
Oh, I'd have to say Jessica Savage or Barbara Walters, even though she might not be as popular to some.
And you think you might fill those shoes one day?
Well, I'd like to. I hope I can do as good a job interviewing as you.
Oh, well, that's very kind of you. Is this girl smart or what? Hey, thank you very much. There's Lonnie Fernandez. She needs to be in our diplomatic corps. Julianne Jaburka, Pompano Beach, 23, Florida Atlantic University. What are you studying there?
I'm studying political science.
Now, what are you going to do when you get out of school?
Probably open a clothing boutique. I know they don't go hand in hand, but I worked in retail several years since I was in high school, and my real love is to have my own boutique.
I see mentions of things like scuba diving. You really into that?
Yes, I love it. I've lived in Florida for 16 years, and I've always had an interest in the ocean, and I love to swim. And scuba diving is one of the most incredible experiences.
I'll bet it is, and so is this for you. Good luck.
Thank you.
Julianne Jaburka. Lynn Haynes, 20 years old, Florida State University. Oh, we could get into some heavy things with Lynn, but we won't. We'll ask her about her pet chicken instead. A pet chicken.
Well, I have a little dog that I got from the animal shelter the day before she was supposed to be put to sleep, and she's a combination of a shepherd, a Doberman Pinscher, and a dachshund, so she's got these little big legs. And then I also, in the backyard, have a chicken, which I've raised since she was about 3 weeks old, and she stays back there with the dog, and they keep an eye on the house for me.
Is this an attack chicken?
Of course.
I'd like to see that one day. You'd like to meet George Burns, why?
Well, he's been around for a long time, and I feel that his experience is worth a lot to meet somebody like that and talk to them and find out what their mistakes were so you can try to avoid them.
Lynn, I've been enjoying talking to you. Good luck to you.
Well, thank you.
Lynn Haynes. Susan Gentile is next. Come right on over here. St. Petersburg, 22 years old. Now, you would like to be, and apparently you are already active in public relations and as a model. What are you going to be doing in the future?
Well, I hope to finish school and attain my REA license, which is my real estate license, and someday successfully open a firm or agency of my own.
For fun time, you do some motor crossing, do you?
Well, that's really on weekends. Every weekend I go out, and I used to be just a spectator watching the motocross, and I finally got tired of standing around and watching all the guys ride the bike, so I figured I'd give it a try, so I race Powder Puff Motocross.
Well, the lady does what she wants to do. Good luck to you, Susan.
Thank you very much.
Susan Gentile. And Leanne Jacobowski, student, University of Central Florida. What kind of a degree are you after?
I'm after a bachelor's degree in business and mathematics.
How do you see yourself in a few years?
Oh, as a successful career businesswoman.
Any particular business?
No, not really. Whichever one will take me with a math and business degree.
Why are you interested in that field?
Oh, I've loved mathematics ever since I was a little child, and I think it's a great field. It's like a foreign language.
Leanne, you're probably putting together, if you'll pardon the pun, some pretty good numbers here tonight with our judges. Good luck to you.
Well, thank you very much.
Leanne Jacobowski. Now I have the opportunity to introduce our panel of judges. These folks have been mighty busy over the last 3 or 4 days, starting with the personality competition and going right into last night in the swimsuit, the evening gown, and here they are doing the job this evening. Let me introduce first Mrs. Florida 1981, one of the top 10 finalists in the Mrs. America pageant, and she is executive secretary to the First Lady of Florida, Adele Graham. Please welcome Jean Mosley. This gentleman is Executive Vice President of the Metroplex Communications and General Manager of radio stations WHYI-FM and WHTT-AM Fort Lauderdale. He's a native of Cleveland. He has managed 6 radio stations and produced several public television shows and specials. He is Dave Ross. A A lovely and talented young lady crowned Janet Chesser just a year ago here at Parker Playhouse, currently pursuing a career in modeling. Welcome Miss Florida USA 1982, Lisa Smith. Then we have international attorney and longtime pageant judge who has served in more than 100 competitions. You meet the dean of Miss USA State Pageant Judges, John Bell. Some of you may have seen the stunning international beauty on the recent Miss Universe pageant. You met her earlier. Professional model and author, Miss Universe 1978, Margaret Gardner. This 12-year veteran of newspaper and television journalism in South Florida, columnist for the Fort Lauderdale News and Sun Sentinel, please welcome Ron Simpson. Since 1963, she has hosted the Good Morning Show on WCTV in Tallahassee, veteran pageant judge also involved with numerous charity affairs, and has been an anchor for the annual Muscular Dystrophy Telethon. And here is the wife of Robert Riedel, Anna Johnson. A member of the Broward County Board of Commissioners, who has served twice as mayor and one term as vice mayor for the town of Davie. This 35-year resident of South Florida is Scott Cowan. Editor, Vice President of Broward's leading visitor publication, Travel Host, the magazine found in the area's finest hotels, this judge is an active member of the community's overall effort to improve tourism. Would you meet, please, Ina Lee. And there we have met our judges, and we will continue in just a moment.
The Miss Florida USA pageant is brought to you in part by Roger Brown's World of Miniature Horses, where 48-inch miniature horses perform daily from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. Take Florida Turnpike Exit 24 in Pompano Beach. We will return to the Miss Florida USA pageant after these messages.
Your makeup may help hide a wrinkle, but mine can actually help prevent wrinkles from coming along too soon. My makeup is Moisture Whip by Maybelline. Moisture Whip is formulated with moisturizers and Patamate O, so it protects you from dryness and too much sun to actually help prevent wrinkles from coming along too soon. Moisture Whip, beautiful makeup by Maybelline. It's good for you to look beautiful.
Greater beaches, greater courts, greater racing, greater sports. Hollywood, Pompano Beach, Lauderdale by the sea. If it's in greater Fort Lauderdale,
it's the greater place to be.
Greater dining, greater sights, greater days and greater nights. Greater ports and greater sales.
Welcome back to the 1984 Miss Florida USA pageant. And here's our special guest performer, Jim Gibson, singing the theme from Ice Castles, Through the Eyes of Love.
Please don't let this feeling end. It might not come again. And I want to remember reaching out to touch you. How I feel so much since I found you, looking through of love. Now I can take take the time, I can see my life as it comes up shining now, reaching out to touch you. How I feel so much since I found you. Looking through of love. Now I do believe that even in a storm we'll find some light. Just knowing you're beside me, I'm this feeling end. It's everything I am, and I want to remember how it feels to touch you, how I feel so much since looking through the eyes of
contestants plunged into the busy schedule of preparations, rehearsals, and photo sessions for the pageant. Some have had the opportunity to get to know the greater Fort Lauderdale area. As the host of the pageant, Broward County welcomes the participants with open arms and has its chance to show them that greater Fort Lauderdale certainly is the greater place to be. Just watch.
From throughout the state of Florida, 116 young ladies have come to greater Fort Lauderdale, not only to compete for the title of Miss Florida USA, but also to enjoy the many attractions of Broward County. The contestants begin their tour sightseeing aboard Bahia Mar's famous Jungle Queen, Fort Lauderdale's touch of the Mississippi along the New River. Their relaxing voyage takes them past the plush homes and exclusive yachts of Broward's many waterways that have earned this city's nickname, the Venice of America. Then it's out to the beach, and with quite a splash, the contestants are off to the races and in for some real fun on aqua bikes from Bill Sunrise Boat Rentals, one of the many attractions that keep natives and tourists alike flocking to South Florida's most beautiful beaches. Along the famous beachside strip, the contestants enjoy the balmy tropical breezes aboard the famous Voyager tram, the perfect answer to sightseeing along Broward's lovely avenues. Opting for some action, it's a straight shot down the Thunderball Slide, which is only part of the massive Slidewinder complex at Six Flags Atlantis, an adventure for aquatic thrill seekers of all ages. While some show off their high diving talents, the others enjoy the many other activities available at one of Broward's newest and most exciting attractions. An afternoon at Hollywood's Topokiji Yogini Park allows the contestants to get in some healthy exercise, as well as time to enjoy their new friendships before the hectic pageant schedule begins. Wherever they go, the contestants stay fresh and lovely with Maybelline's easy-to-wear cosmetics. Here at Roger Brown's Miniature Horse Farm, another new and popular attraction in Broward, the contestants find enchanting, huggable horses, which, believe it or not, are full grown. Then it's on to the Everglades for high-speed fun aboard an airboat in Everglades Holiday Park. Lots of open wilds out here, lions and tigers and alligators, oh my. Surprise, girls. Look who's coming to lunch. Lucky he's not too hungry. All in West Broward is not wild. In fact, the beautiful gardens of the Kapok tree lend an elegant and romantic setting to the contestants' afternoon of adult dress-up. Appropriately outfitted, they take a leisurely stroll along the picturesque walkways and classic settings. Speaking of elegance, Fort Lauderdale's exclusive Le Club International, with its gracious setting along the inland waterway, hosts the pageant's official opening ceremonies and orientation dinner. Arriving in style, some of the contestants are greeted by the club owner, Angelo Romani, for a memorable evening of dining and dancing, all in preparation for the exciting pageant nights to come. The contestants home away from home while staying in Fort Lauderdale for the duration of the pageant is Howard Johnson's Lauderdale by the Sea, the official host of the Miss Florida USA pageant contestants and staff. On Press Photo Day, the local media gathers at Howard Johnson's to photograph and interview all the candidates for the title of Miss Florida USA 1984. The fun, friendship, and new experiences are all part of this year's Miss Florida USA pageant.
They sure did have fun. I don't know about you, but that 7-story water slide looked like it would be too much for me. I'm glad that the kind of courage it takes to go down that slide isn't a requirement for the pageant. I never would have made it. The second category for our semifinalist competition is the swimsuit competition. Each of the contestants will be modeling their pageant swimsuit that is our official pageant swimsuit for the Miss USA contest. In the background, you'll be hearing a song that is very special to this city called Fort Lauderdale by the Bobby Lands Band. Dick?
Terry, those suits are designed especially for our contestants by St. Maxime's, and we're ready to present them now for our swimsuit competition, beginning with Lori Martinez.
Some people tell me LA's real nice, Honolulu is a tropical paradise.
Lori is 20 years old from North Miami and a student at Warner Southern College. Young lady would like to be an anchor woman on TV. Next, it's Kimberly Scarborough. Kimberly Scarborough is 20 years old. She attends Florida State University. Her hobby time takes her into modeling, traveling, and water sports. And Kimberly Roberts is next. From Hillsborough Beach, she's 22 years old, attending Florida Atlantic University. She talks ambition. She thinks of being an elementary school teacher, a public speaker. She enjoys running, like to be a marathon runner. Next, we're ready for Michelle Weldon. Michelle is 20. From Jacksonville, her school is Florida State. Interested both in acting and in modeling. Kathy Morton. Kathy from Hialeah, 21 years old. She goes to Miami-Dade Community College. Enjoys dancing, skating, racquetball, and running.
Just wanna go back to Fort Lauderdale.
Diane Scholler. Diane's from Hollywood. She's 19. She's a model. Like to be in TV commercials and on magazine covers, so modeling is her thing. Here is Lisa Campbell. Lisa from Fort Lauderdale, and she's a student at Florida State. She enjoys dancing, gymnastics, skiing, and tennis. I'd like to own her own dance studio one day. Here now is Krista Henricks. From Miami, she's a student at UCLA. Like to go to law school. She enjoys jogging and swimming, water skiing and riding. Stacy Hosperder. Stacy's at Florida State. She's 19. Leisure time takes her into jazzercise, jogging and dancing, and water skiing. Robin Gallus. Robin is from Miramar. She's 23. Looking for her pilot's license. Also enjoys chess, photography, and water sports. Lonnie Fernandez. Lonnie is from Clearwater. She's 20 and attends Troy State University. She enjoys nautilus and swimming. Like to be a television broadcaster. Julianne Choverka. Julianne from Pompano Beach. She's 23. Goes to Florida Atlantic. Has fun at scuba diving and reading, water skiing, boating, and tennis. Lynn Haynes. Lynn from Tallahassee. She's at Florida State. She's 20 years old. Likes poetry, all sorts of athletic activities. Interested in modeling, marketing, and advertising. Susan Gentile. 22 years old, from St. Petersburg. Likes public relations work and modeling. Has fun at ice skating, skiing, diving, and gymnastics. Mm-hmm. Leanne Jakubowski. Leanne from Winter Park. Now, she's 20 years old and a student at University of Central Florida, looking for a degree in business and or start a career in modeling. Liking cooking, enjoys watching football, too. Now, for one more look, may we have all of our semifinalists please right up into the front of the stage area so that our judges can take one more look for swimsuit competition. Of comparative judging, get ready for your turns now, please. Once again, turn.
We're getting closer to finding out who will be Miss Florida USA 1984. We have one category left, and that is the evening gown competition. We'll continue with the Miss Florida USA pageant right after this message from Maybelline.
Your makeup may help hide a wrinkle, but mine can actually help prevent wrinkles from coming along too soon. My makeup is Moisture Whip by Maybelline. Moisture Whip is formulated with moisturizers and Patamate O, so it protects you from dryness and too much sun to actually help prevent wrinkles from coming along too soon. Moisture Whip, beautiful makeup by Maybelline. It's good for you to look beautiful.
Greater beaches, greater courts, greater racing, greater sports. Hollywood, Pompano Beach. If it's in Greater Fort Lauderdale,
it's a greater place to be.
Greater dining, greater sights, greater days and greater nights. Greater ports and greater sails.
Greater what?
Fort Lauderdale.
Now there's a place where make-believe really does come true. Roger Brown's World of Miniature Horses. Fall in love with tiny horses that perform for you and swim in their very own pool. They'll even pose for pictures. See them run and play on 15 acres of fun. There's nothing like it in Florida. The World of Miniature Horses, West Atlantic Boulevard, Pompano Beach.
Moist, wet, wonderful colors. Colors that lick your lips. Moisture Whip colors by Maybelline, with moisturizers and a protective sunscreen to keep your lips very soft, very moist, very wet. And I think that's very wonderful.
Moisture Whip lipstick by Maybelline, for long-lasting colors that lick your lips.
Welcome back to the Miss Florida USA pageant. We have one category left in the semifinalist competition, and that is the evening gown competition. While the contestants change into their gowns, we'll take a look at some more fun the contestants had before the pageant. Here's Kathy Armadine, Christine Kelly, Jamie Nichols, and Michelle Sharp with their interpretation of Pat Benatar's Hit Me With Your Best Shot.
Hit me with your best shot. Hit me with
With the title of Miss Florida USA goes tremendous prestige, as well as the opportunity to represent her state in the Miss USA pageant. And there is more, much more, including an exciting prize package to tonight's winner.
Barbara Bowser Bond, Miss Florida USA 1980, touches up for her evening with Maybelline's easy-to-wear line of cosmetics for eyes, lips, face, and nails. Maybelline's prize package of clean, fresh, wearable cosmetics for the look you love also includes a $1,000 cash award to tonight's winner. The new Miss Florida USA will be flying to New York on Eastern Airlines. Whether she chooses a flight from a southern, central, or northern part of the state, she'll be traveling nonstop with Eastern, America's favorite way to fly. Miss Florida USA will be traveling in comfort and style this year in a beautiful new Chevrolet Camaro from Fort Lauderdale's Gary Fronrath Chevrolet. First class is the word for this stylish, standard-equipped automobile for a full year of safe and carefree travel for Miss Florida USA. From Sue Gordon Bridal Salon, a $1,000 selection from her lovely line of evening wear. Elegant, chic, sophisticated, whatever her style, Sue Gordon Bridal Salon has just the right look. Throughout all her official travels, whenever Miss Florida USA comes to Greater Fort Lauderdale, she will be an honored guest at Howard Johnson's Resort, right on the beach, Lauderdale by the Sea, the official host for the Miss Florida USA pageant. Whether it's on the beach or relaxing by the pool, Howard Johnson's is a year-round favorite for those in search of the ultimate in Broward County's fun and sun. Le Club International is the backdrop for a preview from St. Maxime Swimwear, South Florida's solution to sophisticated playwear. A $1,000 cruise wardrobe from St. Maxime's is one of the gifts for tonight's winner, as well as special gifts of clothing to all finalists. Along with a custom crown by Aubrey Creations and sash by Krause & Sons, 1984 Miss Florida USA also receives a $500 savings bond, an all-expense-paid trip to the official 1984 Miss USA pageant, a custom-designed state costume, and a personal appearance contract. During her busy and exciting reign, Miss Florida USA is provided with ample opportunity for relaxation, a year of unlimited travel from Dolphin Airlines, an all-expense-paid weekend for two at Miami's Hyatt Regency Hotel, from Chalk Airlines, a round-trip ticket to the Bahamas for a weekend stay at the Grand Britannia Hotel in Paradise Island, an all-expense-paid weekend for two at the Conover Ramada Renaissance. All this and much more for the lucky Miss Florida USA 1984.
Now for the most elegant part of tonight's pageant, the evening gown competition. Each contestant will be modeling her own choice of a gown. The judges will base their scoring on poise, charm, and a flair for fashion. This is the final category in the semi-finalist competition. Dick?
Terry, we're all set. You folks at home and those in our audience here, may we present our evening gown competition, beginning once again with Lori Martinez. Year-old Lori from North Miami says her prized possession is a 12-string Sunburst Ovation guitar. She is into playing that guitar and singing those songs and looking very nice in her evening gown tonight. Kimberly Scarborough. This 20-year-old from Tallahassee, looking for success, has ambitions in the field of fashion and eventually owning a dress salon. Kimberly Roberts is next. Miss Roberts is 22. He Hillsborough Beach or home? Describes her ideal man as being strong and sensitive, gentle, and with brown hair. Sounds like she knows somebody. Michelle Weldon. From Jacksonville, Michelle is 20. Spending some time modeling in New York. Likes that idea of modeling or acting. Now here is Kathy Morton. Kathy, 21 years old and from Hialeah. Her ambition is to get a degree in physical therapy. She is very active, likes dancing and skating and racquetball and running. Coming out now is Diane Scholler of Hollywood. She's a 19-year-old model. She enjoys boating and skiing, just likes relaxing on the beach. She's in the right place for it. Lisa Campbell. Lisa is 21 from Fort Lauderdale. She could do some visiting. She'd like to go to Hawaii. Her leisure time in dancing and gymnastics, also like skiing and tennis and racquetball. Krista Henricks. ...19 years old from Miami. She apparently has done some visiting, been to Mexico, Spain, Germany, France, Holland. This is the young lady who'd like to be a lawyer one day. Stacy Hosferter. Now, Stacy is 19. She's at Florida State. Has her eye on the entertainment field. Her hobby list, well, she puts down jazzercise and jogging and dancing, water skiing, and cross stitching. Here is Robin Gallus. Robin, 23 years old from Miramar. She lists as a famous ancestor, the 11th president, James K. Polk. Next, it's Lonnie Fernandez. Mm-hmm. 20 years old from Clearwater. She'd like to visit Spain. L- Bonnie again has her eye on the television business as a career. For fun time, enjoys swimming and Nautilus. Julianne Choberka. From Pompano Beach, student at Florida Atlantic. She's 23. I'd like to get involved in fashion design. Her leisure time spent in scuba diving and also water skiing and boating and tennis. Lynn Haynes. Lynn is 20. She's a student at Florida State as well. Says that she would like to visit England should some travel opportunities come around. Modeling, marketing, and advertising, her areas of interest. Susan Gentile. Susan would like to further a career in print modeling and commercials and television. 22 years old, from St. Petersburg, already active in public relations and in modeling. Leanne Jacobowski. Years old, from Winter Park, student at Central Florida. Hobby time, likes biking and cooking. When she's serious, she's thinking of getting that degree in business. Well, that does it. That completes our semi-final competition. Now, in just a moment, we go to the next step, and that's choosing the five finalists, one of which will win this title, Miss Florida USA. We'll continue after these messages.
Your makeup may help hide a wrinkle, but mine can actually help prevent wrinkles from coming along too soon. My makeup is Moisture Whip by Maybelline. Moisture Whip is formulated with moisturizers and Patamate O, so it protects you from dryness and too much sun to actually help prevent wrinkles from coming along too soon. Moisture Whip, beautiful makeup by Maybelline. It's good for you to look beautiful.
Greater beaches, greater courts, greater racing, greater sports. Hollywood, Pompano Beach, Lauderdale by the sea. If it's in Greater Fort Lauderdale,
it's the greater place to be.
Greater dining, greater sights, greater days and greater nights. Greater ports and greater sails.
Greater what?
Fort Lauderdale.
Next is the awaited announcement of the five finalists. While the judges' votes are being tabulated, let's take a look at the fun some of our contestants had at a ranch way out west in Davie. Here's Brenda Aiello, Julianne Choberka, Kathy Morton, and Marty Reisinger with radio station Y100's marketing director, Tony Novia, as the boy from New York City, and our version of the song by Manhattan Transfer.
Ooh, ah, ah, come on, kitty, that's about the boy from New York City.
He's kind of tall. He's really fine. Someday I hope to make him mine.
Yeah.
It's about the boy from New York
City. He's really down, and he's no clown. He has the finest penthouse I've ever seen in town. And he's cute in his mohair suit. And he keeps his pockets full of spending loot. Ooh, say you ought to come and see his dueling scarf and brand new car. Oh, yeah. Oh,
ooh, ah, ooh, ah, cool, cool kid.
Oh, yeah.
Dance about the ball from New York City.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
He can dance, take a chance with a little.
And make romance.
Dance, baby, because he's a looker.
That's when I fell in love with just one glance.
I'm sitting here with Janet Chesser, the reigning Miss Florida USA for 1983. Janet, how are you feeling right now? You're about to give up your title in just a few moments.
Well, I feel quite a bit different than I did last year when I was in this position, not knowing if I would make the top five. But I feel a little bit sad, but I feel excitement for the new girl that's going to win because she's going to have a really good year ahead of her, and it's really going to be good for her, so I feel glad for her.
Well, I think that's very nice, Janet. I know that I was very happy, too. What I want to know now is who will be the five finalists. Dick?
Ladies, thank you for that. We're all waiting for that information, and I think it is prepared. May I have that envelope once again? Thank you. Yes, another tense moment. Get down to turning 15 into five finalists. And once again, I say at random, no particular order, good luck to each one of you semi-finalists. Our first finalist is Lynn Haynes. Our next finalist is Kathy Morton. Three more out of this group, and the next finalist is Stacy Hosberger. Finalist, Krista Henricks. One more name on our list of finalists, and that is Lisa Campbell. There you have our finalists. I'll be back in just a moment with a very brief chat with our finalists after this word from Maybelline.
Maybelline thinks you should be pampered all the way to your lashes. That's why they invented a mascara so rich, so gentle, it's named Rich and Gentle. Rich thickness plus gentle care. How thick? You choose with the exclusive Maybelline Dial Control.
Feel free to use all you want. It washes off without irritating rubbing. The gentle formula pampers your lashes. Rich thickness plus gentle care.
Rich and Gentle Dial Control Mascara. Only from Maybelline.
Now there's a place where make-believe really does come true. Roger Brown's World of Miniature Horses. Fall in love with tiny horses that perform for you and swim in their very own pool. They'll even pose for pictures. See them run and play on 15 acres of fun. There's nothing like it in Florida. The World of Miniature Horses, West Atlantic Boulevard, Pompano Beach, opens Saturday, July 16th.
If you're between the ages of 18 and 24 and want to learn how you can participate in next year's Miss Florida USA pageant, just send a postcard with your name, address, telephone number, and date of birth to Miss Florida USA, in care of Tel Air Interest, 1755 Northeast 149th Street, Miami, Florida, 33181. The Miss Florida USA pageant is the official preliminary to the Miss USA and Miss Universe pageants. It's more than a pageant, it's an opportunity.
You're our inspiration. Maybelline knows how you use eyeshadow, so we created new Expert Eyes, the first shadow kit matched to the way you use it. You get lots more lip color.
Because you use more. Experts matched the contour and highlighter and added makeup tips right in the package.
That's why it's guaranteed to make you an expert. Expert Eyes, with lots more lid color. It's matched to the way you use it.
For you, from Maybelline.
By this time, we pretty well know these finalists, but ladies, very quickly, a refresher course. I want to pass in front of you with a microphone. Just tell me who you are, your age, where you go to school, that sort of thing. Lynn, we'll start with you.
I'm Lynn Haynes. I'm a 20-year-old marketing major at Florida State University.
And next?
Hello, I'm Kathy Morton. I'm 21 years old. I'm from Hialeah, and I'm attending Dade Community College.
All right, Kathy.
Hi, I'm Stacy Hosperter. I'm 19 years old, and I attend Florida State University.
And next?
My name is Krista Hendricks. I'm 19 years old, and I'm a student at UCLA.
Lisa Campbell. I'm from Fort Lauderdale. I'm 21, and I go to Florida State University.
There they are, one of these young ladies in moments will become the new Miss Florida USA. Ladies, would you take that special position for this musical salute that we have prepared for you, especially for our finalists, while the final decision is made? Here once again is our guest performer, Jim Gibson.
This song will never sell, they'll never understand. I don't even sing it well, I try but I just can't. But I sing it every night, and I fight to keep it in, 'cause this one's for you, this song's for you. I've done 100 songs, from fantasy to lies, but this one's so real for me, I'm the one who cries. But I sing it every night, and I fight to hide the tears, 'cause this song's for you, this song's for you. This song's for you wherever you are. Say that nothing's been the same since we've been apart. This one's to say that all I can do is hope that you'll hear me sing, 'cause this song's for you. I've got it all, it seems, for all it means to me. But I sing of things I miss, things that used to be. And I wonder every night if you might just hear me too, 'cause this song's for you, this one's for you. This song's for you wherever you are. Say that nothing's been the same since we've been apart. This one's to say that all I can do is hope that you'll hear me sing, 'cause loves. This one's for you. Oh, this one's for you. Same since we've been apart. Oh, this one's for you.
Before we know who will be the new Miss Florida USA, we'll find out right after this word from Maybelline.
Are gonna drive people wild.
With a sleek design in lipstick, Ultra Slim by Maybelline. Ultra Slim lipstick is long and slim with a slant tip for easy control. To go easy around the curves, easy around the corners, to shape beautiful lips in racy, creamy colors.
Your lips are gonna drive people wild. Ultra Slim lipstick by Maybelline.
Now there's a place where make-believe really does come true. Roger Brown's World of Miniature Horses. Fall in love with tiny horses that perform for you and swim in their very own pool. They'll even pose for pictures. See them run and play on 15 acres of fun. There's nothing like it in Florida. The World of Miniature Horses, West Atlantic Boulevard, Pompano Beach.
This vacation, do something sensational in Greater Fort Lauderdale. Stay 3 days, 2 nights from just $29 each, including a lot of bonuses, like discount coupons good for big savings at award-winning restaurants and loads of Greater Fort Lauderdale attractions. Imagine 3 days, 2 nights starting at $29 each. Call toll-free 800-432-5545 for details. The Greater Fort Lauderdale vacation, it's sensational.
If you're between the ages of 18 and 24 and want to learn how you can participate in next year's Miss Florida USA pageant, just send a postcard with your name, address, telephone number, and date of birth to Miss Florida USA, in care of Tel Air Interest, 1755 Northeast 149th Street, Miami, Florida, 33181. The Miss Florida USA pageant is the official preliminary to the Miss USA and Miss Universe pageants. It's more than a pageant, it's an opportunity.
Year ago here in Parker Playhouse, we named Janet Chesser as Miss Florida USA, and well, her year of reign has gone by, and in just a few moments, she'll turn that crown over to one of the five finalists that we have on our stage right at this moment. For her final walk and farewell to the crown and title of Miss Florida USA, once again, here is Janet Chesser.
One year ago, all of my dreams of becoming Miss Florida USA became a reality far more exciting than I had ever imagined. I can never put into the words the joy of experience of being Miss Florida USA. It has been a springboard to the future and a constant learning experience. The friendship and support of the people I have met will remain with me forever. I want to thank my boss, Ron Rice, for his wealth of understanding and patience during my year of travel and responsibilities to the pageant. A very special thanks to my mother and father for encouraging me to do my best at all times. Without them, I could have never achieved many of my goals. To Mary Lou Gravett, thank you for the friendship, laughs, endless shopping excursions, and your never-ending patience. Thanks to all my friends at Tel Air for all your help. For all your support and advice, thank you, Chuck. To all my friends and the 1984 Miss Florida USA pageant contestants, I wish to say, dream your dreams and they will come true. I love you all.
Concluding her reign as Miss Florida USA, Janet Chesser. Now we've come to that moment that we have worked toward all evening. I will go for that official word, and again, thank you, sir. We'll name our fourth runner-up, third, second, first runner-up, and our new Miss Florida USA. Ladies, before I do that, let me say this, that we would be proud and happy to have any one of you represent us in the Miss USA pageant. Is that correct? These ladies are outstanding. Five beautiful finalists. Standing by now, in the first envelope, the name of our fourth runner-up, and that is Kathy Morton. Turning to the next envelope, the name of our third runner-up, Lisa Campbell. Now, to name our second runner-up, Krista Henricks. One of these young ladies going to win this title. Lynn, how do you feel right now?
Scared.
Scared to death. Stacy?
Great.
Do either one of you have any idea where you are? I imagine it's tense right now. We're ready. One will be the first runner-up. The other will be the new Miss Florida USA. And who will it be? Our first runner-up is Lynn Haynes, the winner and Miss Florida USA, Stacy Hosperter. Old from Florida State University, Stacy Hosperter is the new Miss Florida USA. Receives the crown, the sash, and now for her first official walk as Miss Florida USA, Stacy Hosperter of Florida State. Stacy, what did you just say?
I said I'm so excited.
I bet you are. I heard every time I said your name tonight, as was the case in many of our contestants, there was a pocket of fandom for you here. Where are they? Who is that? Who all is here tonight?
Well, my family and some friends from Tallahassee in Miami.
Tell me again what you're into at Florida State. What are you studying?
Fashion merchandising, and I'm taking theater.
Didn't you say, what else were you involved in up there?
Modeling.
Modeling, too. Are you going to continue at Florida State, or will this take you away for a little while you perform these duties? Can you do both?
It might take me away for a little while. It's worth it.
That doesn't make you too sad, huh?
No, not at all.
I want to ask you this. Before this pageant, I think I know the answer to this question. Before this pageant, were you ever in another?
Yes.
Yeah, I know. What was it called?
The Watermelon Pageant. Panhandle.
Is that a rapid rise to stardom or what?
Or what? Yes.
Where was that held?
Chipley, Florida.
Chipley, Florida?
Yes.
Well, now, after this, what doors would you like to see open? Here you are, the new Miss Florida USA. This show is seen by as many people as almost any telecast we do for the Miss USA people. What would you like to see happen to you?
Some doors opening and modeling and maybe a little acting.
Let's hope it does. Good luck and congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you all.
Stacy Hosperter, Miss Florida USA.
Congratulations, Stacy Hasfurter, Miss Florida USA 1984. What a beautiful lady. She has a wonderful year ahead of her, representing Florida in the Miss USA pageant in May. And she's got all kinds of new experiences and growing and just a lot of fun. Now I would like to say thank you to all of the contestants for participating tonight, and a very special thank you to everyone who's contributed to the pageant. For myself, I'm Terry Utley saying good night, everyone.
The 1984 Miss Florida USA pageant was brought to you by Maybelline. Maybelline helps every woman bring out her own special beauty with a complete line of cosmetics for eyes, lips, and face in the latest fashion shades. Everyone can be a winner with Maybelline. And by the Broward County Tourist Development Council, Greater Fort Lauderdale, Hollywood, Pompano Beach, Lauderdale by the Sea, and Deerfield Beach. There's no greater fun under the sun. Some travel arrangements for the Miss Florida USA pageant were made through Eastern Airlines. Whether you're traveling on business or pleasure, chances are Eastern has a convenient nonstop going your way. Come fly with Eastern.